Hi there! In this video, I'll show you how to create a Freepik contributor account to upload and sell AI files. We'll explore the steps involved in creating an account, preparing and uploading your files, and I will also tell you which is the best time to upload your AI files so that they will be accepted faster. Let's get started. You will find a link to this page in the video description. Click on the Become a Contributor button. You can create an account using your Google or Facebook account or by entering your email address and password. Click on Sign Up. Accept the terms and conditions. Choose a username and your country. The rest of the fields are optional. Click on Start Uploading. You can start the onboarding process by clicking the Start Onboarding button. This will take you through a guided tour of the Freepik contributor dashboard. If you prefer, you can close the pop-up window by clicking the X in the top right corner. To become a Freepik contributor, you must upload 10 of your best AI files in JPEG format, with a size between 2000 pixel and 10,000 pixel on any of their sides, and in RGB color mode. You will only have 2 attempts to get accepted, so please make sure your files meet the requirements. When you first download an image from a generative AI software, it will be in PNG format and will be around 1024 pixels or less in size. To upload it to Freepik or other similar platforms, you will need to upscale it. There are many sites and softwares that can do this, both free and paid. I personally use Topaz Gigapixel AI, which is a paid software that costs $99.99. I will make a video about it later, but for now, I will only show you how to make sure the image is larger than 2000 pixels in both dimensions and how to choose JPEG format and RGB color. To upscale the image, choose 2x or 4x for the size. Then click Save Image and choose JPEG for the image format and Preserve Source Profile for the color profile. To upload your files to Freepik, click on the Upload Files button. You can either drag and drop the files or click on Browse and select them. Once the files have been uploaded, click on the See Uploaded Files button. After that, click on the Edit button next to any file. Select one image of your AI images. For AI files, you need to turn on the Created with Artificial Intelligence checkbox. A new field will appear that allows you to sell your prompt along with the image that was generated with it. This means that when someone clicks on the prompt to see it, it will count as a download. Personally, I don't upload my prompts. I did it the first time when I uploaded my 10 files to Freepik because I thought it was required, but after that, I stopped doing it. It's a lot of work to do, and I also don't want other people to see my prompts for pennies. There are other platforms that pay better than Freepik for prompts. Freepik doesn't check if the prompt is giving the same result or not, so it's up to you whether or not you want to upload it. Enter the title of your image along with 50 or fewer keywords. Freepik will sometimes generate keywords automatically for you if it can recognize your image. You can add a release if your image has people or properties. A release is a document that gives permission to Freepik to use your image. You can find a template for a release on the Freepik website. Personally, I have uploaded AI images that have people's faces on them to Freepik without a release, and they have been approved. However, I do not recommend uploading images that have people's faces or properties if you are not sure that they are not based on a recognizable person or property. You can select all images by going to Select and selecting All from the drop-down menu. This will allow you to turn on the Created with Artificial Intelligence checkbox for all images at once. This is helpful if all of your images are AI images and you want to avoid repeating the same process for each image manually. To deselect all images, repeat the same steps, but this time select None. If some of your images share the same properties, such as the title, you can select them all and give them the same property to avoid repeating the same process for each image manually. This is called batch editing. To batch edit images, follow these steps. Select the images that you want to batch edit. You can do this by holding down the Ctrl key and clicking on the images. Make the changes that you want to the selected images. For example, you can change the title, keywords, or release status. Then click on the Save button. It is important to click on the Save button after you have made changes to the selected images. Otherwise, your changes will be lost if you refresh the page. If you have 10 images that meet all the requirements, the Submit button will be clickable. However, if you have less than 10 images, you will not be able to submit your images for review. You need to have exactly 10 images to submit them for review. Once your images have been reviewed and approved, you will be able to submit more images. As a level 1 contributor, you will only be able to submit 10 images at a time. Once you have had some of your images approved, you will be promoted to level 2. This will allow you to submit a minimum of 10 and a maximum of 500 files at a time. After that, you will be promoted to level 3, which will allow you to submit a minimum of 10 and a maximum of 3,000 files at a time. This usually happens within a week or so if you keep uploading high-quality images to Freepik. How to get your images reviewed faster on Freepik. The review time for images on Freepik can vary, sometimes taking just a few hours and other times taking up to a month. There is no way to guarantee that your images will be reviewed quickly, but I've noticed a trick that might help, although it's not guaranteed to work every time. Upload your images during business hours in Spain. Freepik is a Spanish company, so their business hours are from 9 a.m. to 6 p.m. If you upload your images during 9 a.m. to 11 a.m., they might get reviewed faster. But remember, this doesn't work all the time. If it has been more than 20 business days since you submitted your images to Freepik, and it has not yet been reviewed, you can contact Freepik support. Once you contact them, your images will be reviewed as soon as possible. That's all for today's video. I hope you found these tips helpful. If you have any questions or suggestions, please feel free to leave them in the comments below. And don't forget to give this video a thumbs up if you found it useful and subscribe to my channel for more exciting content like this. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.